direction cosine of a vector, a very important topic. Okay, and this is a point AB is a vector and point P is any point in the three dimensional plane. Okay, so now let us move for the direction cosine. Now if a vector makes alpha, beta and gamma with the axis of x, y and z respectively, then cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma are called direction of a vector. Is it clear? Now we are having a vector AB. Now let AB vector is equal to x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. Vector AB is equal to x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. Now draw OP parallel to AB such that OP is also equal to AB. Now these two vectors AB and OP we have to draw parallel to, and when it is a parallel such that OP is equal to AB and in same direction. Therefore, vector AB is equal to vector OP. Now, draw PQ PS and PR perpendiculars from point P to x axis, y axis and z axis respectively. Since vector AB is equal to vector OP, therefore now when these two vectors are equal, then the resolved part of AB along coordinate axis is equal to resolved part of OP along axis. Okay, it means if AB vector AB is with x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap, then coordinates of P are also x, y and z. Okay, now also we can write it now that I can just mention here only. OP is equal to what? OP is equal to position vector OP, sorry, it is equal to position vector of P, that is x comma y comma z. Is it clear? Now therefore, now we are having this one OQ, OS and OR. Now therefore OQ, vector OQ is equal to x I cap, vector OS is equal to y I cap and vector OR is equal to z k cap. Vector OP, if vector OP is equal to vector R, then vector R, length of vector R is equal to x square plus y square plus z square. Okay, and vector R is what? X I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. One thing. Now if alpha, beta and gamma be the angles, alpha, once again just look here, alpha from here to here, beta from here to here and gamma from here to this point. Okay, so I have mentioned all the angles differently. If alpha, beta and gamma be the angles of vector AB is equal to vector OP along x axis, y axis and z axis respectively, then now here, then x, y and z, then sorry, not x, alpha, then alpha, beta and gamma, then alpha, beta and gamma are called direction angles. These are called direction angles and cosine of these angles are cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma. Called direction cosines. So once again I have cleared the definition part once again. Okay, now alpha, beta and gamma are called the direction angles, and cosine of these angles, that is cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma, these are called direction cosines. Direction cosines. Now direction cosines of a vector is generally denoted by L is equal to cos alpha, M is equal to cos beta and N is equal to cos gamma. Okay, now how we get this one? Okay, now we can write it there. You can just check it. I have drawn three different figures, first, second and third, for each angle. Now because we are having PQ is a perpendicular on the plane, PS is perpendicular and PR is perpendicular. Okay, so now in triangle, now in right angle triangle, POQ cos alpha is equal to OQ upon OP. Cos alpha is what? OQ upon OP. Now we can write it L is equal to, if now suppose we have to write in the vector form, we can write it L is equal to OQ upon OP. This implies L is equal to xi cap upon OP. Now what it is? X square plus y square plus z square. This one, vector R, that is OP. Okay. So, and this will become x upon square root of x square plus y square plus z square. Similarly, you can go for this part and this part. Okay. Now, for this part, we can write it M is equal to cos beta, and this is equal to B upon square root of, sorry, Y upon, it will be y upon square root of x square plus y square plus z square. For this part, n is equal to cos gamma, and this is equal to z upon square root of x square plus y square plus z square. Direction cosines of a vector are represented by one thing, y upon and okay, or even we can write it, or you can write it. Now direction cosines, I have already mentioned that these are called L, M and N, okay. So we can write it, L is equal to x upon mod of vector r, x upon length of vector r, that is what, x square plus y square plus z square. So this is in the short form, okay. Now last thing, now if L, M and N are the direction cosines and direction cosines we can also write like this, direction cosines, this is, if L, M and N are the direction cosines of a vector r, then L I cap plus M j cap plus N k cap is a unit vector in the direction of vector r. Is it clear? So this is a simple concept for you. This is all about a direction cosines of a vector.